Welcome to the distinguished members, friends, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to present my topic, that is solid waste management and circular economy, challenges and strategies. This is one of the important topics in the context of India and particularly this national clean air program. As solid waste management has contributes a lot to the air quality through different chains, right from this generation to disposal. As we know, wastes are categorized under different categories: municipal solid waste, biomedical, plastic, electronic, industrial and hazardous, agricultural, and other waste streams like construction and demolition, battery and all other wastes. These are the waste categorization. Coming to the municipal solid waste statistics in India, I am giving the recent figures on total quantities of waste generated during 1920 and the total generation. You can see from slides 150847, this is tons per day, and out of that only 146,000 tons per day are collected, and out of that only 70,973 tons per day are being treated, and among them 40,863 tons per day are disposed of at the landfills. This is the 1920 figure, and the figures are likely to change due to a lot of constraints. Waste generation in India is expected to be 165 million tons by 2050. And if this situation continues, waste disposal area required will be 1,240 hectares land per year. And if the requirement for setting up of landfill, if we go for 20 years of 10 meters height, it will require 66,000 hectares of land to dispose of the solid waste. So you can see the quantum of area required for disposal of wastes. And we have seen from different reports, including CPCB and Ministry of External Affairs and from other sources, waste generation is likely to increase from 62 million tons to 165 million tons by 2030. Coming to the other waste statistics in India, there are quantum of wastes being generated from biomedical wastes, plastic wastes, hazardous and electronic waste. Although these figures are not accurate due to, as if you see biomedical waste, there are a lot of wastes being generated due to COVID activity, and as per the reported information, 5.6 million tons per year of this biomedical wastes and plastic wastes are being generated, 0.17 million tons per year of biomedical waste, and similarly electronic waste 1.5 million tons per year as per the reported figures. But these reported figures will be changed as per the recent, if we conduct the recent survey. NIRI has carried out long back nationwide survey on waste statistics, particularly municipal solid waste, in 59 cities of India as per the instruction of Honorable Supreme Court of India through Central Pollution Control Board. And this was the overall figure, and that figures were used for Jawaharlal Nehru Urban Renewal Mission detailed project report preparation. And after that, no such mega studies have been carried out by the government. We have submitted a lot of proposals, but that has not been finalized till now. Sanitation is very important. Why sanitation is important, critical particularly for India? Because it saves lives. If you say the disease varia, which kills around 100,000 children in India, due to lack of sanitation, physical and cognitive stunting are being done in children, which produces potentially less productive future workforce, along with this security of women and dignity. These are important aspects which require full sanitation for Indian citizens. What are the challenges for solid waste management in India? There are lot of challenges, right from lack of human resources, appropriate manpower, infrastructure, low collection, waste collection facility. Many of the municipalities, they have insufficient budgets to cater the needs for appropriate solid waste management. Although there are limited technologies available for solid waste management system, and also we have been unable to comply the rules and regulation framed by the Government of India for appropriate solid waste management system. Government has initiated a lot of programs right from 1986, starting under Environmental Protection Act, that is Central Rural Sanitation Program, followed by Total Sanitation Program in 1999. Then a major program was initiated by Government of India through Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission in 2005. Then government came out with new sanitation policy, that is in 2008, followed by Nirmal Bharat Abhiyan in 2012, and the most recent by our honorable Prime Minister, that was initiated Swachh Bharat Mission, Clean India Mission in 2014, and followed by 2015, a program on Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation was initiated, and after the completion of 5 years of the Swachh Bharat Mission, Swachh Bharat Mission 2 was initiated in 2020. As per the World Bank study in 2007, it says that due to lack of sanitation, this India costs around 6% of our GDP. This is sanitation. How sanitation is important, that reflects the World Bank study reported in 2007. Under the Swachh Bharat Mission, which was initiated in 2014, which includes total sanitation, including cleanliness awareness, massive program awareness program was initiated, and the final game was to eliminate, to reduce open defecation, which is one of the main causes for deaths of thousands of children in a year. The program was aimed only for the construction of latrine. Swachh Bharat Mission made an initiative for establishing an accountable mechanism of monitoring of solid waste management issue, particularly collection and transportation. These were the main achievements during SBM 1, and also this public awareness was provided, which emphasized drawbacks of open defecation and promotion of the use of latrine. And there were many these proper and dedicated ground staff were also recruited to bring about behavioral change and promotion of this latrine use in Swachh Bharat. The progress is remarkable, particularly some of the aspects. If you come across 35 cities and urban these territories, and they have identified many of the regions as open defecation free. Only 32 these West Bengal ULBs are still remaining for open defecation free, and this is being reported from Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs in 2020-21. Similarly, coming to the waste to energy, 90 waste to energy plants are functional with an input to the capacity of 0.074 lakh tons per day, along with that 44 more plants are under construction stage to the tune of the capacity of 0.12 lakh tons per day. And there are 1,311 operational waste to compost plants with a daily capacity of 0.6 lakh tons of waste, and another around 400 plants are under construction stage to the tune of the capacity of 0.1.4 lakh tons. If you come across the figures, you can see from these slides, individual household toilets constructed, what was the target? The construction is more than the target, that is 106% individual household toilet. If you come across the community and public toilet, the construction is 122% have been achieved. Garbage city, free city, open defecation free, all these things around 100% have been achieved. Coming to the solid waste management, as per the figure, waste generation is 143. There are many figures reported from different agencies. Some figures are 150,000 tons per day and processed is 1 lakh tons per day, and 100% door-to-door collection system is 86,000. But there are mismatch in the figures reported from different agencies. So, in a systematic scientific approach needs to be followed for effective solid waste management system for any particular city, for any preparation of TPR. They should initiate what are the literature, what are the international efforts on various issues, and then identify, analyze the situations, addressing different aspects right from institutional arrangement to managerial and policy issues, and then identify problems issue-wise, and then set a target, a strategy for its improvement, and for that research and development in solid waste management is very much required. And this should be carried out considering the various national efforts being taken following Supreme Court guidelines, regulation on waste management, and latest solid waste management rules 2016. Then comes to concept of integrated solid waste management system. For any cities, whether it is tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, integrated waste management system is advisable, where the waste generated from households are properly collected, then comes to transfer station. There are two options: recover materials through recycling and composting, adopt waste to energy system wherever is possible, and then finally goes to the landfill, where this ash and landfills are also being dumped, which is being generated from waste to energy options. These are the concepts of integrated solid waste management system. New categories of wastes which were initiated since the inception of this COVID-19 in 2019 December, and there are a lot of processes during COVID-19 and how to utilize various techniques for its proper management. This is highlighted through these techniques, and recently this has been published in a very good journal where we have highlighted from where how the solid waste management, right from generation to collection, different chemical disinfection, sealing, temporary storage, transport, treatment through various incineration, pyrolysis and microwave. Similarly, special technologies are being used, this GPS for waste generation estimation, tracking of vehicle, route and collection optimization, features monitoring, site selection, all these things, and then data acquisition techniques are being adopted also, and then different these tools are being used like ANN, ENFIS, SVM, this genetic algorithms for different prediction of waste generation, classification, bin level status, routing, illegal dumping and management costs, and then UV rays also utilized for killing or destroying the viruses. So these are the techniques for solid waste management process during the COVID-19. Then comes to circular economy. Circular economy is not a new concept. It is being done at many places since many years back in India also, but that was not highlighted. But nowadays it is very common. You can see how to achieve circular economy means nothing should go out. Everything should be utilized properly. Where it is utilized for biofuel, bio-CNG, all these things which is recently been launched by Honorable Prime Minister in Indore. So all the things to be utilized properly. That is. Now the move from a linear to circular economy. So linear approach to go for circular economy. Ensure in that category access for all the basic waste services and deal with the focus on waste prevention and feedback loops, as well as dealing with the hazardous substances in wastes, that is bring hazardous waste under control. This is also one of the important aspects where hazardous wastes are being separated and particularly from hazardous healthcare waste from different waste stream and manage them separately in an environmentally sound manner, and for that holistic approach for management of all residuals as pollution control and concentrate contaminants from air emission as well as wastewater from hazardous waste. So these are, if we tackle the problem at the source by closing a clean material cycle and with a specific emphasis on hazardous waste substances in wastes and ensuring access for all to basic waste services, we can move from linear to circular economy. Now the question comes, why circular economy is important? There are three reasons. To effectively address the increasing generation of waste quantum and associated environmental pollution, the figure is 2 to 3 billion tons of municipal solid waste is generated globally, and among them East Asia and Pacific has the highest contribution among world's region, generating around 468 million tons, that is 23% are being generated from Asia Pacific. Second is to effectively address scarcity of resources, water and land. These are in a scarce condition. So, and this accelerated by climate change, due to these are being scarcity due to climate change problem, rare earth metals and minerals, animal feeding, this clean water, food, agriculture, all are in scarce because utilization is more and the things are constant. And capture wasted economic resources. Each year, make waste linear economic cycle loses around 80% of the $3.2 trillion of global consumer products. Due to these three conditions, circular economy is very important, and we have to utilize all the aspects in a very different fashion so that nothing is wasted. We have come across utilization of solid waste, how municipal solid waste, industrial plastic, food waste, biomass, paper, how it can be used in a different fashions. That is demonstrated in this slides. We can see this from waste and how it goes from different categories of whether it is biomass, agricultural, utilizing different techniques, using thermochemical conversion, different soil amendment, carbon sequestration, and other aspects, removing toxic components, utilization of biochar. In this circular chart, we have demonstrated how the solid waste can be utilized in a different fashion. This is the recent paper which we have published in a very good journal, ChemSusChem, the how plastic waste can be utilized through different options in an integrated way of different categories of plastic waste, whether it is PP, PS, PET, HDP, PVC, from different techniques how we can utilize, coming to the value-added products, chemicals, all these things, fuel generation, and this can be utilized as a solvent also, construction products. This has been demonstrated in this slide. Now the biochar has become one of the famous aspects. If you come across the literature, biochar research has a quantum jump since last 5 years. If you go across any of the reputed journals, you find maximum papers are coming from biochar, and various centers are being established on biochar. Even if you go to the different universities, state universities, many students, many faculties are working on biochar. So role of biochar in circular economy is also very important. This is publishing very recently. Next year it has been revised and we have submitted in process safety and environmental protection, how the different wastes, how it can be utilized biochar for different purposes, whether it is remediation of toxic metals, utilization in agriculture, catalyst precursor, and mitigating greenhouse gas emission, and how different production techniques like hydrothermal carbonization, gasification, pyrolysis, and torrefaction can be used, and if this can be done, This will improve the circular economy using biochar. There are plenty of opportunities from waste management. What are those opportunities? First is waste minimization. Waste has a big market. Waste has a latent resource and a waste to energy. Employment generation and economic development. These are the opportunities where this waste can be. Finally, what are the recommendations for circular economy best zero waste management system? I have categorized in three categories. First is circular economy and life cycle production, materials, resources and design, share distribution and reuse, and zero waste. Whether it is circular economy and life cycle production, coming to the bioeconomy agriculture, we can utilize circular economy, urban area planning, smart city, infrastructure, building, because these are the new concepts which are coming in the city. Circular industrial parks, if you go to China, I have visited many circular industrial parks in China. Circular economy in energy production, coming to the material resources and design. So life cycle, design of product and process, any design of the environment is very important. Input for sustainable extraction if required. Materials from renewable sources and recycling, and disassembly and component reuse. Coming to the share distribution and reuse, reusable packaging and circular logistics, extended producer responsibility, sharing economy pilots and mainstreaming and product as service pilots. So coming to the zero waste, so improved household waste management, adopting different R, whether it is 3 or 5, increased recycling rates, utilization of construction and demolition waste, kitchen organic waste and biomedical waste management. And this way we can achieve zero waste management system. Thank you very much for your kind attention. We will be happy to answer if any question arises, and I will be in some of the meetings for having question and answer session. And if I am not available in any of the meeting, you can pass the questions to Ms. Chanchal, who will interact with me, and I will finally answer whenever I am available. Thank you very much for your kind attention.